Hello, I'm Robert. Welcome back. This is another one of our Bob Ross paintings, a spring off from it. This one will do a little bit of the autumnish type colors, and we'll try to give it some nice vibrant life. So let me show you what I've done already. I've got a black canvas in this case. I put some tape around it so I'd get a border. You don't necessarily need a border on yours, but if you want a border, you know, put some masking tape on it. Then on top of that, I put a very, very thin coat, super thin coat, worked it into the canvas of a liquid clear. Work it in. If there's too much on it, you're going to have trouble, so be very careful. Be stingy with it. Rub it into the canvas. If you have too much, take a little bit of a paper towel and just touch it to get it, the excess taken off. On top of that, I've added some strokes of Indian yellow. So I put Indian yellow throughout here, and that's where I am now. Our colors today will be Indian yellow. We'll do some cad yellow, maybe some sap green. Some midnight black, titanium white, liquid white, and maybe dark sienna in it. So we'll see what we can do on this one. So again, this is an autumn type painting, and let me remove Bob and we'll get started. Okay. So I'm going to start and find my brightest spot. I'm going to go into a little bit of the cad yellow. I've got the Indian yellow on here already, so I'll put a little, this could be my brightest spot. So I'm just going to X out. And I'm going to add some more. Each time I do these strokes, I'm going to start from the center. So I want to make sure that I have a clean brush before I go back in. So I start in the center again, and I work my way up. With just little X's. My brush again. Just going to do it with the paper towel to get the excess paint off of it. And then I'm going to fill it with the cad yellow again. Come back in the center. And work out. It automatically gets lighter as I get higher in the sky. So I'm going to leave some of these spaces here. I want it a little bit blotchy, so that's going to be our cloud formation. Turn the center again. Working out. Clean my brush a little bit. Added a little bit of titanium white. Because I wanted the brightest spot to be down here. X all the way up. Brush. So I'm going to now just clean my brush again. A nice dry brush, and I'm just going to smooth this out. Barely touching. Little X's. Go lightly across. Okay, so I have my brightest spot still right there. I'll come a little bit more into that section. That's the whitest, that's titanium white, and then I'm maxing it all the way out. And then lightly across. Then I'm going to work with my fan brush. I'm going to make a little bit of a dark color in here. This is burnt sienna. So I'm just going to scribble in here a little bit of a cloud pattern. The brush. Grab a little bit of the titanium white. And I think I'm going to go right over that dark. Brush. And with my plain 1-inch brush, I'm going to softly with just a corner, and softly blend. Just a corner, a few hairs at the end. I'm going to lightly lift up, just a few, again, light, light, barely touching, lifting up, then across, lightly. Just to soften it and blend it. So now we have a nice soft cloud pattern in our sky. So now I'm going to work with darks. I've got some midnight black here and a little bit of sap green. I'm going to mix that. Brush. Lots of paint at the end of this. I'm taking the rounded end on this brush and I'm just going to tap up and pull out. Almost like a printing press stamp. I'm just using the corner of the brush, tapping in, pulling out. Okay, we're coming down, and I'll just tap in some darks down here. We'll come back and highlight all that in a minute. But I'm just getting this nice base down so we can come back and highlight. Okay, we'll put a little bit of dark over on this side. And this will be a mixture again. Our base is basically dark, but it's a dark mixture of midnight black with a little sap green in it. Come up into here. And then we'll just get some color down here. Again, this is just putting some nice darks down. So we can highlight with a lighter color. Tap in a little foliage. This is again just a dark. These are out in the distance. Clean our brush again. In this case, where again we're cleaning with odorless paint thinner. So we'll take take our palette knife, and I'm going to take a little of that brown, a little bit of white, get a little bit of a marbly effect, and we'll just add a few. So I've got a little bit of titanium white with my burnt umber. Come over here. You can put as many of these in as you wish. give us our effect of a little bit of a forest area with a downhill slope. So we'll clean our palette knife. And we'll come in with some titanium white. Use our 1-inch brush. And I'm going to put a little titanium white in there. Just kind of pull this down. I'm going to clean the brush. Go lightly across. And just give us a little bit of reflected water. Clean the brush again. We'll pick up a little bit more of our titanium white. Down here. And just reflect that a little bit. Lightly hitting the canvas. And then I'm going to come in with, I've got this rounded brush. I'm going to mix up a little bit of CAD with the Indian yellow. A little bit on the end and highlight. Indian yellow, CAD yellow. aluminum white. And some liquid white. Highlight the branches. Maybe we'll pick up a little bit of the nice bright red to give it a little bit of a punch. So I'll pull some red off. Clean the brush up a little bit. So I tap into the red, then I tap into the liquid white, pretty color. A little bit over on this side. I'm going to add a little bit more cad yellow. With the red. Then I tap it into the liquid white. Make your clumps. Tap it in, pull it out. So again, what I do here is I grab my color, which is the yellow. Then I come over into my liquid white, and I tamp that into here. Liquid white makes it looser, so it's a wet paint sticking to a thicker paint. And I just tap in. Tap in, pull out. Think clumps. Get a little more red in it to it, so I tap into the red. And I tap into my liquid white, and I just press out. Then I'm going to take a little bit of phthalo blue . I'm mixing the phthalo blue with the red. Tap in a little bit of that color. Come down here and we'll start some little bushes down at this part. Start tapping in. A phthalo blue. I'm going to add a little bit of green to it. Clean the brush. have a little bit of a green color on here. I'm going to put that into the reflected down into the water. Clean the brush. I'm going to go slowly across, lightly across. Just building some reflections down here. Clean the brush. Lightly across. With our palette knife. I'll just put a little bit of a shoreline in here. Trees coming up. Here. Across. Take the tape off. Looks with the border. here we have our nice autumnish type scene. Working into autumn. Very basic. You can add some more water lines if you wish. Maybe put a cut in a couple of these. It's up to you. Add a few more stems. Okay. Hope you enjoyed it. Rather easy. Got a lot of simple colors in there. It's on a nice black color canvas, so all the colors come out vibrant. So, again, I'm Robert. I hope you enjoyed it. See you soon.